You're welcome.
Thank you.
big as that one. And the dog needs something a bit lower.
Thank you. James Fields, I'm the minister of this church. Delighted to see you all. We are here today to say thank you for the gift of Yvette's life, to acknowledge all the many things she has accomplished through the living of her days, and with such grace. We are here today also to bid her farewell, to commend her spirit and soul to the firm care and love of Almighty God. In this place today, while we may not say all the things that might be said in her life, most assuredly we will say this. We will say it with a faithful confidence. She is absolutely at peace. And so may you, her family and friends, those who have shared the journey, may you find the measure of peace in this place of us. But peace also for the journeys to which, soon enough, we must all return to live and to enjoy. For that is how things should be. May the peace of God rest with you all. Let us pray. Almighty, yet ever compassionate God, we are your children. You know us each and every one by name. You count very hairs upon our heads. You know our stories, the things we dare speak, but those things we hold close to ourselves, fearful of voicing. You are the God who holds us close on those days when we are eloquent, but also on those days, like today perhaps, when we find it harder to express the thoughts that lie within. Of you also it is said that not a sparrow falls to the ground, but you know it. So how indeed we may trust that you know the things we feel, the thoughts we know, and the hopes that we have. We give you thanks, God, for the beauty of the created order, for a world which, for all its travails and worries today, is a world nonetheless full of beauty, of promise, of purpose, and hope. And even today, in this winter season, as the world seems to stand still, we give you thanks that ours is a world forever turning to the new. We give you thanks for what it means to share this world, with a trust that in the sharing, it teaches us truly what it means to be human, to know beyond any doubt. There are times and seasons for all things under the heavens. And today, this is our time to say to Yvette, thank you. And this is our time today, no less, to bid her farewell. Adieu. Conscious of words spoken, those unspoken, I invite those of you who wish to join in the words of our Lord's Prayer, as together we say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, deliver us from evil, for thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory, forever. Amen. Kira.
trees fall, rocks on distant hills shudder, lions hunker down in tall grasses, and even elephants lumber after safety. When brave trees fall in forests, small things recoil into silence, their senses eroded beyond fear. When great souls die, the air around us becomes light, rare, sterile. We breathe briefly. Our eyes briefly see with a hurtful clarity. Our memories suddenly sharpened. Examines gnaws on kind words unsaid, promised walks never taken. Great souls die, and our reality, bound to them, takes leave of us. Our souls, dependent upon their nurture, now shrink, wizened. Our minds, formed and informed by their radiance, fall away. We are not so much maddened as reduced to the unutterable ignorance of dark old things. And when great souls die, after a period, peace blooms, slowly and always irregularly. Spaces fill with a kind of soothing electric vibration. Our senses restored, never to be the same, whisper to us. They existed. They existed. We can be and be better, for they existed.
Inching towards the day when we can sing with confidence and gusto. It's 2 days away, I believe. Nonetheless, I invite you to do that precisely now. I invite you to stand as we sing the hymn. I think it would be judicious to keep our masks on, but to do our level best. There is always a danger that this can feel a little bit like karaoke because we're using the sound system as your accompaniment at the moment. But I fully expect the congregation to win the race. I invite you.
Thank you.
At these I'm not going to steal any of your thunder, but I certainly do want, as always I would, to acknowledge Yvette's birthday on the 29th of April, 1971. You have to kind of reread the date to check that you're really getting the right date. Because we speak with sadness about someone who has died as a young person. Nonetheless, across relatively recent terms of time, therefore, we speak the names of Irene, her mum, Gordon, her father. We say thank you to them for the gift of a lovely daughter who has brought to this world something of eternal beauty. She hails from East London. We speak of her today, of course, as a sister to Janet, to Wendy, to Freddie, to Ricky, and to Anne. And I know that she was an aunt to many, a source, no doubt, of wise counsel, but I understand that she was particularly close to Alison, to Kira, to Daniel. These, I doubt if there is anyone in this church today who knows the journey better than you. Our words cannot come close to expressing the thoughts and the feelings that must be yours today. But I do know in the short conversations we've had that the journey was a good one. We were married in December 2021. Yeah, I really should write that for the day, isn't it? What could possibly go wrong? And Adam, we are all so pleased to see you here today. Because although we won't say everything that could possibly be said about your mum, we're going to say all the things that matter. We're going to say that she was a very beautiful person. We were going to say that she was very wise and gave good counsel. I bet she was quite a good cook as well. And I'm told she was a fabulous mother. And I know, we know, that you will miss her. But we also know this, because we're people of faith. We know this, that one day you will tell stories to your children about her. And you will say that she was the best mother in the world. She was a stock analyst. Latterly, I'm told she was a home executive. I had to look that up. But I think that's got something to do with being a lovely mum. She did a bit of this, a bit of that. Very fit, absolutely loved, great outdoors. She was also a person of genuine spiritual depth. And I'm so glad to see the poem by Violet actually quoted today, because that poem says it all. We can be better because of those who have traveled before us. The people of virtue, dignity, and good values, people just like you there. We can be better. Better. Because they existed. I have such a hunch that she came into the world with a smile. And I have a hunch that she might just have left it that way as well. Knowing that she did everything she could possibly do. There's one important gift that I haven't mentioned. When it came to salsa, she could really teach you a thing or two. Over to you. Thanks.
Extended members of the family. She was genuinely liked and loved us likes school and did well throughout, but she definitely loved dance in its many styles. She also liked and participated in athletics, gymnastics, and martial arts, and was a Brownie as well. Celebrity exercise videos really started in America. Perhaps a few of us may remember Jane Fonda's Feel the Burn. But apparently, Yvette loved the one offered by the one and only Cher. She used to do it often, and that ended up making her the step so that she could really go for it. And go for it, she did. Janet and Wendy recounted that Yvette went through a phase of practicing how to spot and spin or twirl continuously in front of the mirror for what seemed like hours at a time. Such dedication paid her later on in life in many ways. Her brother Ricky introduced her to salsa. And coincidentally, dance brought us together in 2011. As we met on the salsa dance floor at El Grande in Bonsoir. I had a few moves, but Yvette was an advanced level dancer. Yes, she was. But unlike the other advanced dancers who seemed intimidated to the group of us improvers, she asked me to dance and instantly made me feel at ease. Totally. It was definitely a special moment for both of us, and although we didn't exchange phone numbers that night, we eventually met again at another salsa event the following month, and the rest is our history. We got engaged, and our relationship was full of love, fun, respect, honesty, and above all, patience to understand each other's points of view. After a while together, we tried for and were blessed to welcome our son, Adam. One of the greatest joys of both of our lives. We both loved him from the beginning. But throughout her time with us, I knew this whole skirt get me. Yvette has really nurtured and filled him with love. And I'll be forever grateful for this. Yvette wasn't an island. She was loved by family and friends, respected and liked by colleagues, neighbors, fellow school moms and dads, and many others who have met her. Then she chose my side of the family to marry into, and she is truly liked and loved on this side too. As well as sisters in heart, Sherry, her bestie, and her mother, and Yvette enjoyed a few sanctuary spa days, chocolate biscuits, the good veg out in front of the TV, and back in their girl days, clubbing at Schnellers, Candles, and Grandmas. Sherry says, most of all, Yvette was her sister in army, supporting each other through life's trials and tribulations with a whole lot of laughter and hoops. Yvette was my rock, my touchstone, my safe place, my bestie always and forever. Spirituality was a big part of Yvette's life, and how she stayed so grounded. She prayed and meditated, but most importantly, she showed her belief in good. God through how she treated people as individuals with love, kindness, and fairness. Yvette loved nature, but insects and bugs not so much. A bit of a contradiction with me, but it's true. She liked recipe books and watching cooking programs on TV. If you ask Adam, what was Mummy's top favorite programs? MasterChef would be there. In time, I think she wanted to be as good in the kitchen as her mum. She recounted many times how, when they were growing up, mum always enjoyed cooking and entertaining friends and family, sometimes on short notice for unannounced guests. Dad got some cooking skills too, and his double fried chips with ketchup comes to mind. Eating healthy from an early age, Yvette was pescatarian when I met her. Gradually, she led and enjoyed healthier diets. We still don't know how she got cancer, and I'm sure there are a few possible reasons depending on who you speak to. On this note, we all need to take care of ourselves and each other in every way. did you feel something isn't right within your own body, please seek medical help. If you're not happy with the first one, seek a second opinion. If you have to, then take action. Yvette was a private person, and as such, she only shared her battle with cancer with a few people. She was determined to beat it, which she did the first time around, with the help of chemo and radiotherapy, and a few alternative others. The second cone of the cancer encountered months after the all clear was a shock. However, Yvette had a lot to live for, and was determined to beat it again. And she fought with everything she had to the end. I will miss a lot of things about Yvette. Her loud sneezes.
But someone so cultured and well mannered. It always surprised me, I have a Deutsch, how loudly she can sneeze sometimes. I think when it was just the two of us, and used to get startled by her sneezes and really got annoyed with myself for being so scared. Another thing was the real belly laughs, the ones that leaves you struggling to breathe, and you had to leave the room. But sometimes you came back into the room too soon, and something sets it off again. And what were we laughing about? Sometimes funny jokes, but more often than not, it was something totally silly, but I cannot forever for life of me remember that one single joke or what set us off. But I will always cherish those clear memories of us really laughing together. It was a workout sometimes. How would I care to be remembered? Of course, you all have your ways of which you will remember it better, but I would like to remember her as someone with lots of love, kindness, generosity, understated elegance, sharp wit, intelligence, practicality, an analytical mind, fun-loving, who loved a good song and a dance.
For we know this to be honest.
that true love is endlessly patient and forever kind. True love perseveres even when the skies around us darken. True love knows that in keeping a record of the things that go wrong in life, we will find no happiness. But if we can remember the good things, then peace one day most assuredly will be ours. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I reasoned as a child. I made my plans thus. But in my heart of hearts, I knew I was not seeing things in their fullness. It was as if I were looking at them through a clouded mirror. They were not clear. But as I grow older, and perchance a little wiser, I come to see things in a different light, in the light of God's love for each and every one of us. And in this, I find a certain peace. I know this also, that the journey is a long one. Sometimes it seems without end. So I continue to give thanks for these three great gifts of faith, of hope, and love. But love it is that crowns them all. So wherever you can, try to put love first. Yvette, we give thanks that you understood these things, that you lived them, and that you expressed them through the gift of your humanity, through the gift of your love. We acknowledge today all those things that you have achieved uniquely through your faithfulness. You are remembered as someone grown, not as old as we would have wished, but nonetheless wise and kind. And we do not neglect that once upon a time you too were a child cradled in your parents' arms. Yours has been a remarkable journey. And in this church today, we acknowledge that a new journey unfolds. It will take us well beyond the powers of our human understanding. But it is a journey in which we have faith and trust. And so it is that today, in our thoughts and in our prayers, we commend your spirit and soul to the further care and love of Almighty God. May God's peace, Yvette, be your peace this day forward and forevermore. Amen. We're drawing to a close. We'll soon be singing the hymn, Blessed Assurance, but before that, I just a word of gratitude to you all for being here today so that we can all pay tribute to her. We need to leave fairly swiftly at the end of the service to get to the graveside. And I know the great temptation is to gather outside and chat, and that's the point at which we're going to lose track of time a little bit. So, just a word of caution on that one. But I do not want to rush you. I do, however, wish you all well wherever your journeys lead from this place today. And on that note, I invite you please to stand as we sing the second.
Oh,
into this world we step barefooted, and from this world we depart empty-handed. But of this world, in faith, we make something good. May the peace of the running wave and the flowing air be with you on your journeys from this place. May the peace of the still, quiet earth and the stars of the evening sky be with you on your journeys from this place. And may the peace of the sun of all peace be with you each and every one, and those you love, wherever they may be, and wherever the journey leads. May God's peace be your peace. Amen. I invite you, please, to remain standing. Thank you.
Thank you. please come back down to it. Thank you, Chair.
For everything under the heavens, there is a time and there is a season. There is a time for birth. There is a time for relinquishing the gift of life. There are times for sowing the seed, other times for bringing home the harvest. There are times for hard work and human endeavor, just as there are times for rest, in the knowledge that we have given of our best. There are times for holding on with great purpose and sometimes courage to the things we believe, the values we cherish, and the people we care for. Just as there comes a time for letting go with a measure of wisdom, of humility, and an abiding trust. And Yvette, in a world as ours, so bereft of that peace we all seek and need, we give thanks that there comes yet a season of a much deeper peace, a peace beyond our human understanding, and a peace that today is God's gift to you. For all things, a time and a season. From the earth to the earth, but with a prayer and with a trust that the good earth cannot contain our human spirit. Her spirit is free, safe in God's keeping. Amen.
Amen.
Friends, this is your time now, and I know that some of you may wish to place a flower on top of the casket and say your prayers as you place the flower. Thank you, Bobby.
Thank you, James. Take care.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
beautiful mansion, I'd gather us there. Beautiful home, beautiful land, beautiful home, beautiful land, beautiful ground, shining so fair. Beautiful mansion, bright, gather us there.
Oh, it's a bit of reflection. Mum's choice. Can't hear her singing, though.
She's got a mustache, she's singing.
Beautiful mansion, hovering yonder sky. Yes, I shall leave this shore, counting my treasures on, where we shall never die. Carry me by and by, never to sorrow more. Heavenly song, beautiful road, beautiful land, beautiful home, beautiful land, beautiful house, shining so fair. Beautiful mansion, bright, gather us there. Rose, beautiful land, beautiful home, beautiful band, beautiful crown, shining so fair. Beautiful mansion, bright, gather us there. We are.
Yeah. Let's get behind you. And I'm so accident prone, so yeah, hold on to it.
Sorry.
bear, and I'm thinking this is going to make it hug me more than a live bear. Oh, you are. Oh, okay. Oh.
Yeah. Okay, James.
More height
on that's that. It.
I'm worried about the hook. Thank you.
Oh, I was really frightened.